Hi, it's Katrina. From a skeleton found in a cave to a shiny black obelisk, here are 10 of the strangest and creepiest archaeological discoveries. Number 10. Ancient Phoenician Shipwreck. Underwater archaeologists working with the University of Malta recently announced an amazing discovery. They found the remains of a spooky sunken merchant vessel from the days of the Phoenician Empire. This ship was discovered in the murky water near the island of Gozo in Malta. Who were the Phoenicians? They were the direct descendants of the ancient Canaanite people spoken of in the Bible. Today, their descendants have been traced to people living in modern-day Syria and Lebanon. The Phoenicians excelled in maritime activities, meaning they had one of the highest levels of technology when it came to building ships anywhere in the ancient world. Phoenicians used galleys and even invented the birim, which is a galley with two decks of oars to be rowed even faster. The Phoenicians had a stable trading network all throughout the entire Mediterranean, including the nations of North Africa, Sicily, and Babylon between 1550 and 500 BC. The shipwreck just discovered came from around 700 BC and was located at a depth of about 375 feet. The ship sank about 200 years before the eventual decline of the Phoenicians. Scientists believe the vessel was going from Sicily to Malta at the time it was sunk. However, it's not exactly clear how the ship was sunk or what kind of interesting goods were being swapped between these two ancient nations. When did the Phoenicians arrive to Malta? So far, underwater archaeologists have discovered about 20 grinding stones, which may have been used in blacksmith work. They also discovered 50 amphorae, which were ancient pottery containers used to hold a variety of different things. These were discovered scattered throughout the sand on the bottom of the sea floor, and are now homes for all kinds of sea creatures. Number 9. Cave Skeleton. The complete skeleton of a man has been found at the bottom of a cave in Spain. Found in the region of Navarra, his remains date back 11,700 years. And could be the most important prehistoric discovery in the area. The skeleton has been dubbed the Man of Loiseau, and he is one of the oldest ever found in Spain. The discovery was made far from the entrance to the cave back in 2017 by a group of cave explorers. Experts determined that the man appears to have been dumped in the cave on purpose. Thanks to carbon dating, scientists have learned the man was only between the ages of 17 and 21 when he was left in the darkness of the spooky cave. The skeleton is complete and well-preserved, but here's where things get violent. Researchers found a hole in the man's skull, suggestive of a projectile piercing his head prior to his death. They also believe the body had been wrapped in a shroud before being abandoned. Not only is the skeleton creepy because it's a skeleton, but the cave in which it was found is also pretty eerie and not very safe. Locals have known about the cave since ancient times, but nobody has ever explored it fully until just now. It's unclear why the guy was dumped into such an isolated place. There were no other bodies found inside the cave, so it was not a common burial place. Even though he was wrapped in a shroud and covered with ochre, it looks like he was murdered, and then someone disposed of his body. Number 8. Buddha in the Trash. A statue dating back 1,500 years has been found in the trash. And not just any statue either. There were actually three sculptures of the sleeping Buddha found amidst piles of trash outside the National Museum in Karachi. But these weren't recent archaeological discoveries. Instead, they were recovered statues that had been previously stolen by smugglers. The statues were rescued and handed over to the museum. For some strange reason, the museum did not preserve them and clean them up like you might expect. They simply tossed them in the trash, creating a pretty creepy sight with the faces of the ancient Buddhas sticking out between ripped garbage bags. According to officials, the Buddhas were recovered along with 395 other artifacts when police foiled a smuggling operation during a routine patrol. From what professional historians can deduce, the object came from the old Gandhara civilization. Even more disturbing is that they weren't the only relics dumped in the garbage. There were other rare artifacts found piled up in heaps of trash outside the museum, including pieces of history from the ancient Indus Valley culture, which date from between 3,300 BC and 1,300 BC. These people developed standardized weights and measurements, they created sculptures and figures out of metal and stone, and the proof of their amazing accomplishments can currently be found in the garbage in India. But what the heck are they doing there? The National Museum director, Mohammed Shah, defended his department and said, "We have put these sculptures over there ourselves." He claimed that since they were made of black schist stone, that nothing would happen to them. Apparently, they have run out of space inside the museum, so they decided to store everything in trash bags outside until they can build more room. Isn't this strange? What do you think? Let me know in the comments below. Number 7. Basilica of the Holy Blood. When it comes to religious artifacts, there are many that are made up of strange body parts like bones and dried organs. The Basilica of the Holy Blood is home to one of the most sacred relics on the planet. The basilica itself isn't creepy or an artifact. It's a chapel from the 12th century, located in the medieval Belgian town of Bruges. But it's what's housed inside of the chapel that's a little disturbing. The basilica holds a sacred vial which is said to contain a cloth stained with the very real blood of Jesus Christ. The chapel itself is quite extraordinary, but it's really the blood of Jesus that piques the public's interest. According to legend, after the crucifixion, Joseph of Arimathea wiped blood off Jesus' body using a cloth. That cloth was preserved and has been kept for the past 2,000 years. It was first kept inside a safe in the Holy Land before the King of Jerusalem, Baldwin III, handed it over to his brother during the Second Crusade. His brother, the Count of Flanders Diederik van de Elzas, then took the relic to Bruges, stored it in the basilica, and it has remained unopened and in the basilica to this very day. There are some who question the legitimacy of the blood. After all, anything said to be physical proof of Jesus is heavily controversial. However, there is a festival each year known as the Procession of the Holy Blood that brings thousands of tourists into the city as the Bishop of Bruges carries the vial through the streets. The first procession happened in 1291, and it is still happening over 720 years later. Number 6. Decorated Skulls. Archaeologists claim to have discovered human skulls that date back 9,500 years. These skulls were decorated in a very creepy fashion. They were modeled after real faces using clay, then colored to create disturbingly lifelike features. They were found inside of a burial site at a prehistoric village in modern Syria, near the capital of Damascus. Each skull was found inside the same pit, all of them resting in a pile. Even more ghoulish is that they were found underneath the remains of an infant, according to French archaeologist Daniel Storger. Unfortunately, we're not really sure what the ancient decorated skulls were used for. The realism is beyond impressive considering how old they are. They may have been someone's attempt at copying the faces of the dead, and they were almost certainly used in mysterious rituals. What makes them so unique is that archaeologists have never found anything else like them. These are completely unique in Syrian burials and everywhere else in the world, leading scientists to question just why they were made in the first place and why nobody ever tried to duplicate them. Number 5. Creepy Figurines. Some very mysterious Neolithic figurines have been discovered in Jordan. The figurines date back 10,000 years and were crafted by our Neolithic ancestors and placed in burials. This was a time when humans began expanding throughout the Middle East. However, very little in the way of archaeological artifacts have been found from this time. According to Juan José Ibáñez, who was working closely with the discovery, archaeologists found a unique assemblage of artifacts made from flint at the archaeological site of Karaisin. The artifacts appear to depict either humans or perhaps a god or goddess. They were discovered inside burials and apparently crafted specifically for mortuary rituals. And while it's undetermined whether these creepy figures were made to depict men or monster or otherworldly visitor, they are still pretty fascinating. Archaeologists say the figurines were cult objects. This means they were vehicles of a magic hand that would have only been used in ceremonies seen as highly symbolic or religious. Though what types of religion were practiced 10,000 years ago is still a mystery to historians and archaeologists. All we know is that the figures had something to do with the dead. Number 4. The Black Obelisk. The Black Obelisk of Shalmaneser III is a creepy artifact that looks like it belongs in the tomb of an ancient necromancer. Instead, it was originally built to celebrate the successful military campaigns of King Shalmaneser III of the Assyrian Empire. The obelisk was erected back in 825 BC in the courtyard of a central, possibly administrative building in the city of Kalu, also known as Nimrud. The obelisk is carved with four different scenes depicting various military achievements by the Assyrian king. On most of the sides, it shows various scenes of the king receiving tribute, though there is one side of the obelisk completely covered in pictures of strange animals. They seem to be humanoid in nature, almost like humans mixed with monkeys or apes. These bizarre animals are chained and kept on leashes, and scientists haven't quite figured out what the weird creatures could possibly be. As for the place in which the obelisk was found, it was once the capital city of the entire Assyrian Empire. Kalu was a prosperous city throughout much of the empire's significance until eventually it was ripped asunder by civil war and turned into a dusty ruin. Today, the city is located in modern-day Iraq. Number 3. 6,000-year-old massacre. A massacre that happened 6,000 years ago may have been one of the oldest instances ever of indiscriminate killing. The ancient site was found in Croatia, and archaeologists from the Institute for Anthropological Research in Croatia used genetic analysis to try and figure out just what happened for all these people to have been buried in such a ghoulish way. There were 41 people killed here and buried in a mass grave. The genetic study done was one of the largest ever in the history of archaeology. 38 out of the 41 individuals were analyzed for genetics. What researchers found is that they all belonged to the Lasinja culture from the Copper Age. The grave was filled with women and men in equal numbers, with about half being children and half being adults. Some of the people in the burial were related, others were simply part of the population, but they all shared common ancestry. The surprise here is that all the people were from the same place and the same culture. Normally, in mass burials, the people slaughtered are part of a battle. It looks like here there was a large-scale killing that took place that had nothing to do with regular war. It could have happened because of an increase in population size and a scarcity of resources. There could have been a civil revolt. Scientists don't really know the answers. What they do know is that the people were slaughtered indiscriminately, regardless of age or gender, and then dumped inside of a pit and buried. Number 2. Medieval birthing girdle. One of the most dangerous things a woman could do throughout history and even today is give birth. Medieval medicine was a nightmare, and archaeologists have found one of the creepiest and most bizarre contraptions used by doctors about 500 years ago. It's called the birthing girdle, and it was found soaked in delivery fluid, milk, and honey. The girdle was used to help a woman survive childbirth. It was a length of parchment about 9 feet long that was wrapped around the swollen belly. How did this help? The parchment would be covered in prayers and religious symbols. The prayers and symbols were believed to protect the woman from any harm that would come to her during the birth. This wouldn't really pass a safety inspection in today's hospitals, but back in the 15th century, birthing girdles were all the rage because there wasn't much else they could do. For the first time, scientists have actually found one that was in good shape. According to Catherine Rudy with the University of St. Andrews, the birthing girdle came from 15th century England and was discovered with traces of birthing fluid and blood on it, suggesting the woman was still wearing it while pushing out her baby. But what kinds of things would be written on the birthing girdle? It would be scrawled with the names of apostles and saints, and it would have pleas to God for the woman not to be injured during childbirth. In other words, it was a medieval lucky charm. Number 1. Head in a cave. Inside of an Italian cave, a single skull has been discovered miles away from its original burial site. According to Maria Giovanna Belcastro with the University of Bologna, the head was separated from its body, taken away by flowing water, and then lost deep down inside of the cave. It was originally discovered in 2015, deep in a gypsum cave called Marcel Lubon's Cave. While it's true that some caves were used as burial grounds in ancient Italy, the simple fact that no other human bones have been found here confused archaeologists, at least at first. There was nothing except a skull, and even the skull was missing its lower jaw. Based on the structure of the bones, the skull belonged to a woman somewhere between 24 and 35 when she died. The skull dates back to around 3600 BC, over 5,000 years ago during what is known as the Neolithic period. From what researchers can gather, the creepy skull rolled away from its head, probably after being severed during a funeral ritual, got moved by something like a flood, and then was carried all the way to the mouth of the cave, where over the centuries, flowing water pushed it deeper and deeper until it finally wound up in the bottom. So far, the body has not been found. Thanks for watching! Which of these discoveries did you like the most? Let me know in the comments below, and be sure to hit that subscribe button and come back soon for another video. See you later! Bye!